Sector, the Honourable Peeni Henare, here with us. He is going to give an address and then has very kindly agreed also to ask some questions that were floated around earlier in terms of some questions to put to the Minister, which is very generous of him. It's very generous of the Minister actually to be here because ministers have a very busy time frame. And I'm not sure that everyone is aware, but Mr. Henare is also the Associate Minister for Social Development, he's the Minister for Whānau, and he's the Minister for Youth. So on top of being Minister for Community and Voluntary Sector, that's a very heavy workload. So with no further ado, Minister, I'd like to invite you for your address.
Say that the dinner last night was fantastic for those who were able to be there. It was great not only to share in some of the conversations, but also to hear and listen to the ideas that were floated around the dinner table last night. It's neat to see so many passionate practitioners in the sector of charities and communities coming together and sharing ideas, and to do that over a great New Zealand wine and even better New Zealand food. It's a fantastic opportunity. So I want to acknowledge those who I met last night at the dinner, in particular those who have come from afar, from Australia, UK, Ireland, and right across the world who have come here today. And I say to you all, welcome once again. I also want to acknowledge, in the name of the MC, the words of Karen Cunningham. And I want to acknowledge Karen in particular, not because I've dragged her away from the charity sector and put her into another board. But the acknowledgement she has done on the board, and in there paying Roger to yourself and Simon, I want to just acknowledge you. But Karen in particular, knowing full well that her time with the charities board will be coming to an end very soon. And I look forward to working with her on another great co-op that I'm sure still aligns itself with much of the work that charities and communities do for our people across Aotearoa and New Zealand. Also, thank you to the Joint Organising Committee from the Charity Law Association of Australia and New Zealand, the Chartered Accountants of Australia and New Zealand, and of course the Charity Services for hosting this conference. We know just how hard it is to organise a conference, and it's fantastic. All of the feedback we've heard so far has been really positive and encouraging. So, one of the mentions last night was that perhaps this can be a more regular occurrence, and I will certainly endorse and support those words. So this is the first conference of its kind in New Zealand. Similar conferences have previously been held in Australia, although they're not quite as good as New Zealand. The agenda has so many topical issues to stimulate some very interesting discussions. As Minister, I'm committed to encouraging education and awareness about the charitable sector, so I'm delighted to be here with you all today. I'd like to focus my quarter or my speech to you today on two particular areas. These aren't set in concrete or certainly finite. This, as you all know in the charity space, is an evolving process and an evolving conversation. But I want to focus in particular on two parts. Firstly, my vision as the Minister for the Community and Voluntary Sector and the importance of the sector here in Aotearoa, New Zealand. And secondly, to update you all on the progress of the review of Charities Act 2005. It's always important, I've been travelling around the country to make sure that charities and communities get their chance to speak with men, not just in the big centres across Aotearoa New Zealand, but in small places like Pōkitika and Blackwall on the west coast, a population of 30, all related. But it is important that we get to communities like that to make sure that their voices are heard and the work that they do, the important work that they do in their community, is recognised. So I want to recognise them, all of them who are involved in the community and voluntary sector, who give up so much of their time, their passion, to make sure their communities are healthy and thriving across Aotearoa. Their expertise, dedication and experience is crucial in ensuring the success of charities and other non-profit organisations. I acknowledge your support and thank you for your valued contribution. Can I also acknowledge the hundreds and thousands of volunteers across Aotearoa? There are some significant challenges in the volunteering space, and the example I always give is I visited one particular volunteering organisation and we have moved into a new time. Clipboards on the wall, slightly antiquated. And if we're serious about engaging young and future generations in community volunteering and letting them express themselves through volunteering, but more importantly, acknowledging the contribution they make, perhaps it's time we started changing those things. The work of volunteers is invaluable, and I commend you all for the support that you provide right across the country. I was interested in the results of a survey which found that chartered accountants provide 3 hours of pro bono support for the sector every week. My maths isn't the best, so I'll let you work out how much that is per year. While the survey only considers accountants, I am well aware that similar themes and patterns are seen also in the legal fraternity. It's been long recognised that members with professional skill sets volunteer their time generously, and it's great to better understand just how much time that really is. The survey also found that accountants volunteer out of a desire to help their communities. Can I say thank you to you all? The community and voluntary sector is comprised of the 115,000 not-for-profit organisations, and this includes approximately 27,000 charities. These organisations play a vital role in supporting people and communities. During this parliamentary term, I want to explore how to remove barriers to charities and other not-for-profit organisations making a difference in their communities. This is a key priority for our government. My other portfolios also offer scope to ensure the best outcome for the communities throughout Aotearoa. I've been a minister for just on 6 months now, and and I've been lucky to get out and visit organisations across the country. Recently, I visited Gisborne, Waiwa, and Napier, meeting a range of community groups and organisations such as ASEC, or Aotearoa Social Enterprise Trust, which makes preserves in the RSA kitchen, the Waiwa Community Partnership Group, and the Mōrearea Community Hub, all fantastic, passionate community people who want to see their community thriving. Empowering local communities to solve local problems is a key focus for our government. I believe communities are best placed to build on their own strengths, and I want to ensure community leaders are enabled to develop and lead projects that make a difference for local people. Another focus area of the government is growing the social enterprise sector. I understand there's a workshop or session on social enterprise with Stephen, later on this morning, and I'm looking forward to see what dialogue and ideas are entered into in that particular session. Social enterprises work alongside government and communities to provide solutions to big picture social, environmental, and economic problems. And in my discussion with you last night, Stephen, I also talked about the kind of cultural outcomes we expect to see from social enterprise, in particular in a place like Aotearoa, New Zealand. I want to make sure that the sector has the right tools and support in place to continue to grow and make a difference to communities, and I believe that social enterprise has a key role to play. One of the priorities we set about when we took government in November was to review the Charities Act of 2005. I'm committed to supporting the continued success of charities in New Zealand. The government's focus is to ensure that sector enjoys the trust and confidence of the public by making sure the Act works well for charities, the regulator, the various professionals who rely on it, and the wider public. Since the first charity was registered more than a decade ago, we've seen a number of significant changes. The establishment of the Charities Registration Board in 2012, and the introduction of new reporting standards in 2015. The review is a timely opportunity to take stock of how the world has changed since 2005, to hear from the sector and to ensure that the Act remains fit for purpose for the diverse sector that it serves. We need to ensure the Act caters for organisations of varying sizes. Some of New Zealand's registered charities are very well resourced. However, a quarter have an income of less than $10,000 per year. The review will be a great opportunity to hear and address some of the concerns raised by stakeholders over the past few years. I hope to make good progress on the review by the end of this parliamentary term. I expect to be able to formally announce the beginning of the review and terms of reference very, very soon. Over the last couple of months, the officials within the policy group at the Department of Internal Affairs have been engaging with the sector user group to develop the terms of reference for the review. The sector user group has 25 members representing a range of views from the charitable sector. This group has provided extremely useful feedback about the current legislative framework and made many suggestions on ways to improve it. In particular, can I thank three members of the group, Sue Barker, Stephen, and Craig, who are active in organising this conference. It's a pleasure to see you all again. I'm still discussing the details of the final terms of reference with my ministerial colleagues, so I'm limited in how much I can share at this point. However, I can tell you that this will be a legislative review and that the scope of the review will enable robust discussion on substantive issues under the Act. My ambition is to ensure that any legislative change arising from the review will be passed within this parliamentary term. Engagement is more important than this process. Consultation and communication with the sector will be crucial and welcomed once the review is formally underway. Many of the sessions being run at this conference relate to the issues that could fall within the scope of the review, and in my discussion with Matthew here this morning, perhaps this is one of those opportunities we can't miss to make sure that the voices from practitioners here in this room are heard in the review process. I encourage you to make the most of this chance, to think about the current system and how we can improve it. I want to assure you that we will be considering a range of perspectives from the charitable sector throughout this review. This will include the perspectives of small charities, big charities, te ao Māori, and the wider public. It's also crucial that we consider experiences from similar international jurisdictions, such as Australia and the UK. This is so we can identify any strengths that might be suitable to adapt to a New Zealand context. From Ireland. We too are magpies. And it is important that we take the good things and leave the bad things, just as you have done here in learning what works for us and what doesn't, and hopefully that your return home will be richer after your experience here. Engagement with the sector will be critical to ensuring that the legislation is fit for purpose. Beyond that, I also see it as an opportunity to strengthen relationships and develop an understanding of wider issues facing the charitable sector. Can I say once again thank you for the invitation to speak at this event? I'm mindful as a minister and having been a former public servant, or still a public servant, I guess, ministers who come, dump their speech and walk out. I was really quite fortunate, I think, to have spent that time with people at the dinner last night, and I hope that I can spend more time with you throughout the course of the day. I do have a few things I've got to get to, but I welcome the opportunity for individual conversations with as many of you as possible. I'm grateful to be able to acknowledge your support to the wider community and voluntary sector, and to inform you about my areas of focus in the current parliamentary term. I hope to be able to make an announcement about the ongoing Charities Act review very, very soon, and I encourage you all to watch this space and get involved. The secret and wider public consultation during the review will be absolutely vital. So I challenge you to provide as much input as you can. In conclusion, finally, my experiences with the charity sector across the country is one of enlightenment and inspiration. Our people across the country are passionate, extremely passionate, as I know you all are too. What I'd like to see in this particular sector is that passion being unlocked. And my job as a politician and as the minister for this sector is to empower, certainly not to tell charities and communities how to do the good work that they're already doing. An experience recently in Wairua was an eye-opener. The introduction went like this: "Welcome, Minister. Don't tell us in Wairua what to do." But I think that speaks to the passion and the sense of that community in knowing what's good for them. Our job as practitioners and regulators is to make sure that they can get on with what they can get on with, do it well for the benefit of Aotearoa. Mōrere tāngu I tēnei māku, tōna nō, I say tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.